Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create this wedding invitation in Word. So let's open a new document. And the first thing you need to decide is what size paper you need to print this onto. So if you go up to Layout, and you go along to this icon here that says Size, click on the drop down. So as you can see, we're currently in A4, so we're going to switch to A5. And we're just going to increase size of our page. Now what we need to do is to create some graphics, so the leaves behind the text. So for that, we're just going to quickly grab a free image from the internet. It's completely free. So if you just go to Google and type in Pixabay, and we go to pixabay.com, and in the search bar, if we just type in floral, and then over here where it says images, click on the drop down and go to illustrations and then press enter. You can scroll down, you can pick from any of these, it doesn't matter. It's completely up to you and your taste, but for this demonstration, I'm going to select this image here. So all I'm going to do is click and drag it onto my desktop. But if you choose not to do that, you can select it, go to the free download, and then you can select the options here and just select download. Once you've got your image downloaded, go to Insert, Picture, click on the drop down and select Picture from File. And then my download is going to be here on my desktop. And then I just click Insert. When your picture is inserted into Word, you'll find that you can't move it around. So if you select the image, go to Picture Format, go along to Wrap Text, click on the drop down and select In Front of Text, and then you can move it round and rotate it and resize it. So to rotate it, just hover your cursor over the circle and then you can rotate it. And then obviously to resize it, just grab one of the corners and stretch it out. So we're just going to, you can actually pull this up and down without too much of a problem, without stretching the leaves out too much. And again, you can come back to this if you want to and adjust it at the end. So to ensure this is perfectly centered, select it, go to Picture Format, go to Align, click on the drop down and select Align to Center. And that will align that image to the center of your page. Now what we're going to do is we're going to copy this image and just crop it so that we can fill in these spaces at the bottom. So to copy and paste it, we can use Command or Control C, and then deselect your image by clicking away from it, Command or Control V, and there you have a second image. Now what I'm going to do is just rotate this around and then just reduce the size of it. And then I'm just going to select the sort of portion that I want at the top here. I think for the top bit, I used that section there at the top here. So I'm just going to put it roughly where I want to. I will increase the size of it to match the rest of the floral design. But for now, all I'm just going to do is to keep it within my window here, which will allow me to crop it. So if I go to Picture Format and along to Crop, and then all I need to do is to pull in these sides, just select these little black markers and just click and drag, and then just press enter on your keyboard, and then we can just pop that in here. And then again on the larger image, select the larger image, Command or Control C, deselect it, Command or Control V, again resize this one, rotate it. And then we'll take this one down to the bottom here. Let's just crop it. So select it, go to Picture Format, Crop. Again, we'll just bring in the sides here. And we'll move that over to around about here. And then just press Enter. And once you can, again, you can just resize all of this to match the rest. Now you will notice that there's sort of half a leaf here, so you may have to play around with that crop So let's just pull that out slightly. What you want is almost a leaf to overlap another leaf, so it's not so noticeable. Press enter. There we go. So let's put the central text in and see how that all fits. So go to Insert, Shape, click on the drop down and select the square, and then just click and drag out a rectangle. You can adjust this as well if you want to, so don't worry about the sort of size of it right now. So select it, go to Shape Format, go to Shape Outline. It's currently got a dark blue outline around it, so we want to get rid of that, so select No Outline. And then the central part, the central colour, we want to white, so go to Shape Fill, click on the drop down and select white. Now to make sure this is perfectly centred again, select it, make sure you're on Shape Format, go to Align, click on the drop down and select Align to Centre. And I might make these just a little bit wider. Okay, now we're going to select some text, so go to Insert, go to Text Box, click on the drop down and select Draw Text Box, and then just click and drag out a text box. Now all text boxes come with a white background, and if I click away you can see it's got a black border. So we're going to get rid of both of those, so select it, go to Shape Format, go to Shape Outline, click on the drop down and select No Outline, go to Shape Fill, click on the drop down and select No Fill. Then enter some text. I've just copied and pasted some text in. I'm just going to customize this text. So double click inside your text box and you'll find your cursors there. Then just click and drag across all the text, or you can select Command or Control A, which will select all of the text. Then go up to the Home tab, and then you've got all of your text customization tools here. You can change the color, you can change the size, and you can change the font. So I'm using Arial at the moment. And a good technique to using fonts, a very basic technique, is to pick one that has a family of fonts here. So you can mix and match all of these different elements and they will look coordinated. So if you go down all of the fonts, you can see the ones that are family because they've got these little arrows next to them. So you have additional options to pick from. So I'm just going to use the Arial font for now, which is this one here, and I'm just going to reduce the size of this particular text. There we go. Now, once you've got this text box customized, we've taken off the border and we've taken off the white background. Rather than having to do that over and over again, all we're going to do is copy and paste this text box. I can use the keyboard shortcuts if you want to, but actually if you select this text box, and you can do this with any element, whether it's an image or whether it's a shape, if you just hover inside and just hit your Alt or Option key, you can see my cursor changes. Just click and drag and it will make a copy. Now we're going to need three of these, so 1, 2, 3. So in this one here, let's put the names in, so let's just drag this one out a little bit more. So let's just type the names. So let's select all of the text and let's firstly center it. So using this icon here, center text, we'll just center that. And then for this name here, we're going to go to the Arial fonts again and we're going to select narrow bold. And we're going to increase the size of this one to 20. And we're going to do exactly the same with Thomas. We'll go to 20 and we'll take that to narrow bold. Now with these two, we're just going to change what we call the tracking, and it's a really good technique to learn. So select the name, hold down the Command or Control key and select Juliet as well. Right click and go down to font. So within the font menu, if you just go to Advanced, go to the character spacing, and in spacing, we're just going to select 10 points. Now, this has in my Word program, I have a Gremlin, and it automatically changes to another font, but but I'm just going to change it back. So select it, you get a little preview down the bottom here, and then just click OK. So you can see my font's changed. I'll just go up and change that font back. There we go. And obviously you can see the tracking has created larger spaces between each character. Then I'm just going to select the surname, and again, hold my Command or Control key down and select the surname. And then we're just going to go to the Arial family again and select narrow. And then I think we'll just increase the font slightly. There we go. And then we need a little and in the middle, an and sign. I think it's called an ampersand. So again, we're just going to select this text box, hold the Alt or Option key down, click and drag out a new text box, double click inside, Command or Control A to select all of the text. Then we're just going to put an ampersand in the middle. Let's just center that by using the center text icon. And then we can pop that in the middle. I will align all these to the center at the end. Let's just get the text in at the bottom here. So once again, let's drag out this text box, double click inside, Command or Control A, and then you can type all your text in. I'm just going to copy and paste mine. Now let's just reduce the size of all of that. Just increase that a little bit. I can just use my arrow keys to just move that down. And then I might just move these names down a little bit and the ampersand. So once this ampersand's in the middle and you're happy with it, if you select it, hold down the Command or Control key and select the names as well. Go to Shape Format, and you just want this to line up with the center here. Don't line it up with the center here because it'll nudge it too far down. Just line it to the center here. So go to the Align tool, click on the drop down and select Align to Center. Once you've done that and you're happy with the location of this ampersand, go to Group, click on the drop down and select Group. And now that's all one complete group. Then go to Align and select Align to Center. So that's all now perfectly lined up. Again, the same with this one. Align, Align to Center, and again to the bottom, Align to Center. Now, if you use this little zoom tool at the bottom, you can zoom out, and sometimes you can see things that may annoy you or don't look quite right. And it's this point that you can fully adjust that and customize it. So for me, this text is just a little bit too close to the top of this white box. So I'm just going to move that with my arrow keys. And I think these names can maybe come down slightly. The only other thing I would see is that the leaves are slightly closer to the top than they are to the bottom. So click on the leaves. I can just move those down. And in fact, if I click on the larger set of leaves, just move those down slightly. And this one as well. Perfect. So all you need to do now is just to simply print it off. But if you want to send it to a printer as a PDF file, then go to File, Save As, then you can just place it on your desktop or wherever you want it to, and then go down to this File Format, click on the drop down and go to PDF, and then you can select Best for Printing. You can name your document and then simply click Export, and that will make you a new PDF file that you can then send to a printer. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please subscribe and have a great day.